So this through-silicon VR technology, it like many other good things in life, it comes in different flavors, and so you could make this through-silicon VR at the very start of your process flow. That's called as VR first. You could make it in the middle of your process flow, which is MIA middle, or you could actually do it after you're done making your semiconductor chip. So that would be VR last. So let's look into these different flavors of TSV and let's look at the different challenges in each of those. So one flavor of making this TSV is to make it at the very first of the process flow. So what you do is you before you make any transistors on your chip, you first do this etch. So you etch this TSV and you fill it up with your fill material and you polish it out. So you do this TSV process at the very first of your at the very beginning of your process flow. And then after that, you make your transistors. So you do your front-end processing. Remember that most the highest thermal budgets in making your chips are encountered when you make your transistor or when you do front-end processing. So this involves anneals for making your junctions and other high temperature anneals. So most of the thermal budget or the high temperature processes are involved when you make your transistor or in the front end of your chip. And then after you're done making your transistor, then most of your back end of the line processes are typically less than 400 degrees centigrade, or you can also call it low temperature or low thermal budget. So in this TSV VR first, what you do is at the very first of even before you make your transistor, you make these VRs, and then you do your front end processing, and then you do your back end processing, and finally you thin down your wafer from the back till it reaches this TSV. So one of the main challenges with this VR first approach is now since you're making this VR at the very beginning, this VR whatever material that you are filling it, say you could fill it up with copper, or you could fill it up with tungsten, or you could fill it up with polysilicon. So whatever you fill it up with, this fill material and this whole TSV will see this high temperature coming from your front end process flow. So some materials, for example copper, they have very high diffusivity and they can easily diffuse into your silicon at this temperature, so it prohibits using some of these options for your for filling up your TSV. Another way you can make your TSV is to do this via in the middle of the process flow. So what I mean in the middle is do it after your front end. So do your front end first, then do your TSV process, and then do your back end process after that. So this TSV process flow is in between your front end and your back end. So this is how this is a cartoon depicting the same. So you first do your front end process flow. So most of your high temperature anneals occur over here. And then after that done, then you etch out your trench for TSV, then fill it up with your TSV material. So this could be copper in this case. And then you do this back end process flow where you make your interconnects and routing signals and so on. Then finally you thin down your wafer from the back till it touches your through-silicon via. So advantage of doing this scheme of integration is that you now avoid this TSV material from this high temperature anneal step which are involved in your front end. So your TSV material only sees the back end thermal budget, so it sees this back end thermal budgets, but since they are less than 400 degrees centigrade, it doesn't damage your TSV fill material. So you could fill it up with any material. You could fill it up with copper. It's okay to fill it up with copper, and it does not diffuse at these back end temperature. A third integration scheme, which is the via last scheme, would be that you do this TSV integration at the very last. So you do your front end, then you do your back end, and then when everything is done, you come and you make your TSV process flow. So this is a cartoon depicting that. So you first make your front end, so you do your high temperature, all these processes here. Then you also make your back end, so you do your 400 degrees centigrade process flow over here. Finally, you thin down your wafer, and you thin it down before you make your TSV. So it's important to thin it down to the correct depth. And then you start from the back, and then etch out this TSV layer, and then fill it up with this TSV fill material, which is copper. So a challenge in this case is to align this back side with your front side. So you made most of your transistor, then your back end of the line already. So important thing is to align when you're doing this back side processing, align this TSV with the transistor that you have already made, such that it lines up at the exact position that you want it to be. So there could be these different integration scheme. I'm not favoring, the jury is still out actually, which one will be adopted by the industry. But here's a brief scorecard. So I've tried to make this scorecard where you could evaluate your via first, your via middle, or your via last, and you could evaluate in terms of ease of doing the different process flows involved in making your TSV. So for the etching, then to put your oxide, then to deposit your bead layer, and then to do your lithography. So as I mentioned, one of the showstopper for this via first approach is that is the via first approach. This via sees the high temperature, or it sees the high thermal budget. So it restricts the options of materials that you can fill it up with. So it's almost impossible for copper to fill it up with copper, because copper will diffuse into your silicon at this temperature. It's also difficult to deposit it with the tungsten. So this is one of the reasons that via first approach is almost it's being ruled out, because it's not possible for this TSV fill material to survive these high thermal budgets involved in your front-end processing. Via middle is one of the strongest contenders. It seems like an approach which has a lot of things going for it, mostly greens, some yellows, but mostly it's a very strong approach. Via last approach, again, one of the yellow areas for this technology is to do this lithography from the back and align it to the transistors made on the front side. But this is also a strong contender, so this is also an option in play for the TSV integration.